Press pause and answer the question.
This is one of those questions that it's fun. I think it's fun. It makes your brain hurt a little bit. You have to kind of figure out graphically. I think it's always best to figure out graphically how this is going to shake out. So we're given a survey to a group of 30 high school students. 20 of the students were in the band, and 15 of the students run track and field. So some of them do both, maybe some of them do neither. And given this information, what's the minimum number of students who have participated in both band and track? And what's the maximum number of students who participated in both activities? And the correct answer is this one. It's a minimum of 5 students that participated in both and a maximum of 15 students that participated in both. So we can picture it like this. We have this kind of total of 30. We have 30 students, and we have 20 in the band and 15 in the track. And if we kind of put them together, you see they don't fit because that's 35. You know, if we put them together and assume that no one did both, they don't both fit because we only interviewed 30 total students and we have 35 activities. So we had to have at least 5 of them, kind of overlap them like this, at least 5 of them did both. That way we can fit them in. That's the minimum number of students who did both. And then if we're talking about the maximum number of students that did both, well, 15 did track and 20 did band, so it could be that everyone who did track also was in the band. So the maximum overlap is if we take this track circle and we put it inside the band circle, and we see that all 15 of the track athletes also were in the band. So we get our minimum of 5 and our maximum of 15.